Hotel in Nashville, the American General Life and Accident Insurance Company presents the Ralph Emery Show. With today's special guest, Michael Johnson and Cindy Church. And now.
Now we're going to move over here to a fellow that's going to sing the song. Sing a song that might, it might bring, at least in your mind, balmy breezes into your house. It's a tune called Miami Beach. Here's a fellow who is a wonderful singer. Would you please welcome Michael Johnson?
Back in 37, when she first walked down that strip, she was such a knockout, she could make your heartbeat skip. Hiding from the winter, living in a big hotel in Miami Beach. So she lived a long life underneath a pastel sky. She let the ocean bathe her and the trade winds blow her dry. The sun shone on her beauty till it faded clear away. As if waiting for somebody to arrive. Yes, and now the whole wide world has dwindled down to a single wicker chair on Ocean Drive.
Michael, bring your guitar, will you please? Michael, welcome to the show.
Thank you,
Ralph. Have a seat. I got to tell you, I did a show one night on Nashville Now with Michael, and I was determined not to call him Michael Jackson. And it got to be a thing with me. I got mentally all screwed up, and I did well until I did the good night. And then I said, we want to thank Michael Jackson for being here.
Yeah. And I said, thank you.
This album, Departure, is this somehow autobiographical?
Well, the title, I suppose, is it's a departure from the previous music I've done in my life.
Well, the reason I bring this up is because of some of the things you say in the liner notes. You say, there are people I have lost over the years.
Yeah.
Would the following people please contact me at the address below? Who are these people?
Well, let's see.
Are these people you've met in the music industry?
No,
over the years?
No, they're people I went to grade school with and people I went to high school with. I mean, wouldn't you like to do that just to say?
Yeah, I know a lot of people that have passed through my life that I wonder whatever happened
right.
to.
There's a couple old girlfriends in there.
Oh, okay. Who are they?
Judy Height. Hello, Judy.
And who else?
Probably got 9 kids now.
Mary Heron, is she?
Mary Heron is an old girlfriend, yeah.
Camille Kazadisis?
Kazdesu.
Oh, excuse me.
Kazdesu.
Kazdesu.
Right, he's an old buddy from Evergreen, Colorado.
Vincent Zarlingo.
Vinny Zarlingo. He always looked like an attorney when he was like that tall. You could just picture him in tweed. And now he probably is one.
And then you go on to say, you're thanking people.
Yeah.
And you want to thank that guy in Chicago with the tire iron. What is that all about?
Well, those are some of the harder lessons of life, I think. There was a guy in Chicago with a tire iron from whom I learned a few lessons. Some of the tougher lessons. He didn't hurt me, but he threatened me. And I just didn't like that. And I don't know what lesson I learned, but I walked out of there a different guy, an older guy.
Was he mad at you?
He was mad at me, yeah.
What was he mad at you about?
He wanted to sell me something, and I didn't want to buy.
So he threatened you with his tire iron?
Yeah, because I wouldn't buy his stuff,
Okay.
It's like, hey, ain't life...
All right, well, I'm moving on to various autobiographical aspects.
Ah, yes,
okay.
Yes, indeed.
The fact is that most of my friends didn't like each other.
Yeah, that's true.
I hung out in the smoking area with the hoods in high school, but I also was in the choir and on the gymnastic team.
Yeah.
And these songs are all from many different places in my heart. So it's time I introduce them to each other, and you go on to say the departures are also reunions.
Yes.
Interesting.
Yes, indeed they are. I think they are.
So how long has the album been out?
Oh, I think we're about 2 months old now.
Any of these people contact you yet?
No.
So see what he
but
did?
But I didn't go to the reunions either, I didn't go to
the high school reunion. Where'd you go to high school?
I went to North High in Denver, Colorado.
Okay.
So there's usually this big burst of applause right then. Thank you. Now, Kenny Malone is from Denver, right over there.
Kenny, I didn't know that. Are you from Denver? Did you go to North High School?
Yes.
He went to the same high school that you did?
Yep.
All right.
We commiserated. In fact, he played on this record.
And Allison Krauss is on the album, isn't she?
That's right, yeah.
Would you do a little bit for me right here?
Sure. What would you like to hear?
A little Bluer Than Blue.
Bluer Than Blue.
Yeah.
All right.
Big hit for Michael.
Oh.
And I couldn't let you get out of here without doing that.
I'll try this. I usually introduce this song by saying this song allowed me to make the down payment on the home that I can no longer afford. Maybe you'll remember this. I'll just sing you the chorus, okay?
Okay.
'Cause I'm bluer than blue, sadder than sad. You're the only light this empty room has ever had. And life without you is gonna be... What color? Bluer than blue. Bluer than blue. And then it goes...
Don't put the guitar away.
Okay.
From a show called Brigadoon. A little bit of almost like being in love.
Okay. Well, now you...
You have to change the,
not,
the
not
capo.
Can I set this
sure.
over? You have to remember that I was an usher at the Oriental Theater in Denver. And when you're an usher and you see the same movie, 27 times I saw Brigadoon.
I was an usher.
Were you? Okay.
I saw Gone with the Wind 15 times.
Well, then you know.
Yeah.
And you take your break, and you go sit and watch the movie. So I saw the same 15 minutes of Brigadoon 27 times. And in that 15 minutes, Gene Kelly is tap dancing on grass, mind you. And he's singing, what a day this has been, right? What a rare mood I'm in.
Why, it's almost like being in love.
And we did it slightly different. We kind of turned it around and goes like this.
What a night this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love.
You know, I love that.
We did a slightly different version of it.
I love that little guitar lick you're playing there. That's nice.
Thank you.
You know, you are one of the most pleasant singers I've ever heard. So easy to listen to.
Wow, with all the singers you've heard.
Oh, yeah, but you really are pleasant. Just nice to have you in the room. You're going to sing again after a while from this album?
I do. I feel a song coming on right now.
Hey, that's a good song.
I'll hang on to it.
Did you ever, you know, I worked at Lowe's Theater in Nashville for 3 years. And when there's no crowd, you've got nothing to do. And we used to memorize dialogue from the movies that would play. You're bored and you just try to remember the lines. Did you ever do that?
Yeah, I remember June Allison saying, in a World War II Air Force movie, "You're not going to send the kid up in a crate like that, are you?" Remember that?
Yeah.
I don't know which movie.
I don't remember, but I worked in MGM Theater, so I saw June Allison a lot. Okay, and Gene Kelly was one of my favorites, too. We need to take a break. We're having too much fun. When you're having too much fun, they say, okay, wrap it up. We'll be right back.
You're watching The Ralph Emery Show. It's brought to you.
Yeah. Okay. She said it was a small trio.
Oh, yes, yeah. She did. All right. And you were a member of a trio.
I was indeed, yeah.
Chad Mitchell Trio?
Chad Mitchell Trio.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Was he Deutsch then?
John Deutschendorf III?
Yeah.
No, it was John Denver.
It was John Denver in those days?
Yeah, he was John
okay.
Denver.
Okay. Was it Deutschendorf? Deutschendorfer?
Deutschendorf.
Deutschendorf. That's his real name.
Yeah.
Let's go to the telephones and talk to Judy. Judy, where are you calling?
Hey, Ralph, how you doing?
New Hampshire?
Yeah, we just had a bunch of snow up here, too.
Is it on the ground now?
It's on the ground now.
How much?
We got 3 inches up here last night.
Are you in the northern part of the state?
No, I'm in the very southwestern part of the state.
So you're south of Manchester.
Exactly.
Okay. What's your question?
My question is for Michael. How you doing, Michael?
Well, I'm just fine, thank you. That was an easy question, too.
Listening to your cassette Wings.
To my cassette Wings?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
The Ponies?
Yeah.
It's an amazing cassette. I'm a songwriter myself, and whenever I try to get into the mood, I put on this cassette, the song True Love of yours.
Oh, yes.
True love takes a long time to make. But anyway, so you are a great influence to me, and I am wondering who influenced you?
Oh, boy. Lots of different people. I mean, I was a rock and roller as a kid. I liked Chuck Berry and Elvis and Gary and several other people. And then, you know, I liked classical guitarists, and my dad liked Ray Conniff, so I did too. You know, and lots of different sources. But listen, anything I can do to help you get in the mood is just an honor for me. I want you to
know. Okay. All right, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a little break, and then this lady will be happy to know that Michael's going to sing another song right after this. Hey, we're having fun in Music City this morning. We're coming to you live from the Opryland Hotel in Nashville, and we're going back to our special guest, Michael Johnson. And Michael is singing from his album called Departure. There's the album right there. And here's Michael to sing She's Real.
I had stuffed animals when I was just a kid. I dreamed they come alive and play, but they never did. like others I have known. She's real. She's flesh and blood and bone and love that I can feel. She's not perfect, but it's all part of the deal. Yes, I know she's real. Remember my first Playboy magazine. They had photographs in there like I'd never seen. But all in all, they never did have much to say. They just lie there on the
Johnson. Michael, thank you very much, and we'll be back after this.